Hello, today I'm going to show you how to convert an oldie Vespa from AC to DC, for example with battery operation. We have a kit consisting of the Vape ignition, the AC wiring harness and ignition lock. A battery and the most important thing, the cable branch for the DC conversion. You still need various connectors, for example one of these. This is included in the delivery of the wiring harness. The rest is included in the Vape ignition. We need a few standard tools for this. A pair of slide cutters, crimping pliers, wire strippers and a multimeter. And now I show you on the wiring harness how to connect the cable branch to it. So, I have now installed the rectifier in the vehicle, the battery and the additional wiring harness. First, we make sure that the generator supplies the rectifier with the full wave, that is black and blue, goes into the rectifier via black and blue. With blue, it is relatively simple. We take the leftover single blue cable and plug it into a black cable. Which one we take doesn't matter. Next, we also need this black cable. Now we have a little problem. We have two black cables here. Now we have to measure which is the right cable. First of all, let's just pinch this one off. To measure which one of the cables, we insulate it a bit. And now we take our multimeter and set it to the diode symbol. Then it makes a noise. That means we have continuity. Now we can choose which cable to measure first. This cable must now be connected to the second black cable. So that we don't get confused, we first take the cable that we no longer need and pinch it off at about the height of the brush. Now we have the complete alternator shaft connected directly to the rectifier. Next we go to the positive cable from the rectifier to our adapter harness on red. Then we plug these three blue wires into the connector with this red wire. After that, we take the wiring harness from the optional ignition switch. You can't go wrong here. We just go to the black and green down here. We're almost there. All that's missing now is the ignition switch on these four contacts. I'll show you how to connect the ignition lock. We have the green and black wires on the small contacts opposite each other and the yellow-red wires on the large contacts. This means that in one switching position, the current can flow from the red to yellow, in the other this is interrupted. Thus, the ground flows from black to green on the kill switch. The vehicle cannot be started. So, that's almost it now. As you have probably noticed, the negative terminal of the battery is not yet connected. However, we don't connect this until we've made sure that the light switch, headlight, horn, brake light switch, possibly the indicator switch and the tail light are all connected and open connections are insulated. If you don't do this, you run the risk of a broken cable. In the worst case, you could even damage the ignition. Finally, we connect the battery. A small cable is included for this. We'll take a little longer now. I'm now going to go from the battery to the ground, to which the regulator is screwed, and put this to the ground connector on it.
So, jetzt haben wir das ganze System fertig
angeschlossen. So now we have the whole system connected and we can run the scooter on DC. So of course we have the advantage of being able to connect LED headlights, LED turn signals and various bells and whistles to the DC power. More on that later. We have now converted the AC voltage, which is always produced by the ignition, into DC voltage via the rectifier. The same goes out via the red cable and is fused in a battery, which is of course only written down here as an example. For all OLEs, we can use the small scooter battery, which is perfectly adequate for most vehicles. From the battery, the fuse goes to the ignition lock, which goes through to the yellow wire, and then goes through the blue wires into the wiring harness. There it is, distributed to the brake light, horn and light switch. A little hint, the connectors here have not been properly insulated, as one is supposed to do, but we have enough shrink tubing or white connectors in this spark. So you can put it together, however you like. The important thing is to make sure that there are no open connectors. Thanks for watching. If you liked the video, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. If you have any questions, drop us a line in the comments. See you next time.